I had heard this phrase before, and it struck me. It says, may the lamb who was slain receive the reward of his suffering. And I looked into it. This phrase goes all the way back to the 1700s. There's a group of people called the Moravians. And God poured out his spirit on this people in such a specific way that they had 24/7 time of prayer and worship for 100 years. 100 years, 24/7 times of worship and prayer. And I mean, even like the Great Awakening with John Wesley is kind of credited back to this Moravian movement. And then the modern day missions movement also kind of credits the Moravian movement of the Spirit of God. So God did something so specific when he poured out his spirit upon these people. And those in the group that had felt the call to missions, they were so obsessed with the Lamb of God. They would follow the Lamb wherever he would go. And the people that felt this call to missions would sail to a foreign land to spread the gospel. And it's written that their families would stand on the shore as they'd watch the ship leave. And honestly, a lot of them probably would never return to their family, never return to their loved ones. And they would say, they would shout, may the Lamb who was slain receive the reward of his suffering, because he was worthy of it. He was worthy of that sacrifice. And he's still so worthy. He's still so worthy. And so as we sing this song, let's just focus all of our attention upon the one who's worthy. Thank you that you died for us, Jesus. Thank you that your suffering was not in vain, God, that we still receive, God, all that you are. And we want you to receive everything that you can through our lives, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Was on.